Let's talk a bit about crime and rioting. First, let's start with the demand for crime, and we're going to create a demand curve exactly the same way we created a demand curve for the city. Let's assume that everyone either commits one crime or doesn't, and that everyone has their own value of committing a crime. We'll order the people from those who like crime the most to people who like crime the least. We'll then get a series of bars representing the value that each person places on committing a crime. Those bars decline with the number of criminals precisely because we've ordered them in that way. And naturally, we're going to assume that the people who like committing crimes the most are the first people who commit crimes. Now, we do just what we did for cities. We assume thousands of people, and the bars start to get smaller and they smoosh together. Eventually, we're left with a downward sloping curve, which might be a line, but it also might bend a bit. The simple equilibrium equates this benefit of crime with the cost of crime. The easiest assumption is that the cost of crime is some function of the probability of arrest times the punishment if you are arrested. We can write this here as a horizontal line. This graph predicts that the number of criminals falls as the punishment for crime increases, or if the probability of arrest increases. But now, let's switch into riot gear. In riots, where there are really a lot of people breaking the law at any one time, the probability of arrest starts falling and eventually goes to zero. We'll capture this by assuming that first the cost of crime is a horizontal line, just like before, but then the cost starts dropping precipitously because the police are just overwhelmed. Eventually, because the probability of arrest goes to zero, the cost asymptotes to zero. As you can see, there are now 3 points where the two lines meet. A low crime point, which is normal times, a medium crime point, and a high crime, big riot point. The medium crime point is again unstable. If you have a few more rioters, the benefit of rioting exceeds the cost of rioting, and so the size of the riot snowballs. If you have a few fewer rioters, the benefits of rioting are less than the cost of rioting, and so the size of the riot shrinks. There are two stable equilibria, one with a big riot, the other with normal levels of crime. How do you get from the low riot equilibrium to the high riot equilibrium? Some form of coordination device, usually. A mob massing for a sporting event or a protest. A true riot organizer. Maybe even just shared common expectations that a riot will occur. Twitter. How does a riot end? Usually by calling in the National Guard, which means a shift upward in the cost curve, first causing the riot to shrink and then precipitously to disappear entirely.